Hi, you guys, and welcome to Bubble Talk episode 30. Can you believe it's been 30 episodes when I started this amazing journey? I'm your host, Toni Rodriguez, tonight. Thank you for being so patient and joining us late. Thank you to Houston Traffic, but you're not going to bring us down and you're not going to keep Bubble Talk from having episode 30. I'm here with a beautiful, if a lot of you don't know who she is, Kay McCunis. She's about to introduce herself. Tell us a little bit about you and why you are so darn famous. Welcome to Bubble Talk.
Thank you for having
me. I'm so excited that you're here. Well, so tell us a little bit about you.
My name is Kay McCunis. I own Beautiful Anti-Aging Studio.
Okay.
And I love what I do.
And we talked about it a little bit earlier about how does this notoriety start? Like, why do so many people, when I mentioned you were going to be on the show, were like, oh yeah, oh my gosh, I love her, I know her. And tell them what you were telling me in the pre-show chat.
How I started?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I was a geriatric nurse.
Okay.
I did that for about 15 to 16 years. And geriatrics was my love.
Okay.
And I came into the world of aesthetics. I had a certificate for a laser peel. I didn't know what it was.
Okay.
I was 40 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Had no idea anything about aesthetics, really.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't know there was aesthetic nursing out there.
Okay.
And so I loved it because it was beauty and art. It was molding people. It was making people happy. I mean, I did that in the geriatric world, but now this was a whole different world, and I'm very artistic to begin with.
Oh, yeah. You're kidding me.
Like, it was just like, wow, this was just really my niche. So I stepped into that world and absolutely loved it, and that's when I decided after doing that for several years that I needed to step out and do it on my own. So I started training doctors and nurses how to inject.
Mm-hmm.
I trained with one of the bigger companies, that Bellafill, which is a filler that lasts 5+ years. So I started training with that company and then just decided to kind of open up my own place. And it's awesome. And so I decided to start doing the art that I have all throughout the studio. And just to show that beauty and art come together as one.
Sure.
That you're not just sticking people with needles.
Sure.
And my motto is always education, education, education. So I always want to make sure my patients are educated. So they're more educated when they leave than when they came.
And not so fearful of the whole process,
right?
And
it's really, it shouldn't be like that.
Right.
You should be able to talk to someone and get on their level and kind of talk about it so they understand. And so that's what I do.
And leave happy.
Absolutely.
And leave beautiful.
Yes,
and want to leave
people.
And have some bubbles,
mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes, lots of bubbles.
You know what? You know, one of the things that I loved about what you said earlier in the pre-show chat, you said, we didn't want the place to feel so aesthetic and
exactly.
So cold and uninviting.
Right, exactly.
I had a tour earlier of this beautiful location. The art here, she has personally made. Like, they didn't go out and shop and buy it. She had a vision because she is truly a creative, an artist. And this place does not, it feels like an art gallery.
And that's what we want it to feel like.
It's beautiful. And the hues of blue and just how everything correlates.
That's
wow.
What?
I mean, I just wanted to sit down and have bubbles. And I did. Because it's so inviting and relaxing. And I felt very calm. Blues, those hues of blue were very calming. So how long was this process of putting art with the clinic together?
It's been an ongoing process. It's not completely 100%.
Okay.
But I'd say about a little over a year.
Okay.
Trying to get it in process and get it in and just have everything fixed up the way
okay.
we want it. A little OCD, so I want everything perfect. But of course, in the world, nothing's perfect.
Oh, no. We're live.
Right.
We're live. So if we look robotic or something's going on, you guys know we're live. Tell me also a little bit about your backstory. Are you a Houstonian? Born here, where'd you go to high school?
I am a Houstonian, went to Sharpstown High School way back then.
Yeah.
My dad was an engineer, so we did travel overseas and lived overseas, different countries, but basically Houston.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So we have, let's see, a couple of viewers on Bubble Talk. I see Tira, Samantha, I think they're viewing on my page. Hi, you guys. Hi, Gary. Hi, he was one of our photographers at the fashion show on Sunday. Hi, William Rodriguez, thank you for watching. You guys, are you going to the Bubble Talk page? Could you give me a thumbs up and let me know how we're looking or sounding, or if you prefer my page, which is fine, either page, we're happy. that you're watching this tonight. Yeah, I'll upload the better of the two videos. Hi, Brandon, to YouTube, okay, when we're done. So going back, you said you grew up in Houston, went to Sharpstown. Did you aspire to do this as a little girl? Did you think one day you would be the strong female entrepreneur?
No, not necessarily. I'm very strong-willed. I mean, that's who I am. Mm-hmm. But artistically, everything's always been artistically for me, everything.
You're just a visual artist.
I'm visual.
Like, if it's pretty.
But I grew up going to nursing homes and making little things for all the people in nursing homes. I mean, I grew up doing that.
Well, I feel her energy. You know how I am about energy. I feel that she's very nurturing.
Oh, I am very nurturing.
I can tell just in the brief moments before we started that she's, I know nurses. Mm-hmm. I get that feeling of just a really positive, nurturing energy. And that's probably why Boy and Bobby love you so much. Awesome. Because you're awesome. Awesome, awesome. So tell people a little bit about what to expect if they were to come here. You said the consultation is free and education. So
absolutely.
Let us know what that would be like for someone who's never done this process.
So someone comes into the office, we usually give them a tour of the facility. We come back in, we take pictures, and we ask them what bothers them. Mm-hmm. And then if they want to have that type of educational consultation, they mm-hmm. can. It doesn't have to be that way. Mm-hmm. I will say what bothers you is not necessarily what you treat. But people don't realize that.
Because they don't know.
No,
they don't know the aesthetics and how it all works, right?
And I will say that you look at your face like the foundation of a house. You want to fix your foundation before you fix your windows. Doesn't matter how great the windows look if the house is falling. So, you know, that's what you want to fix. But people don't realize that. Because you go in, when people look at themselves, they look at themselves nose down. That's why everybody always wants this fixed. But when people look at you,
really?
They look at you nose up. Because eyes are the window to the soul. Because you know if your kids are happy, sad, glad, mad.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, because you look at their eyes. So eyes are really the focal point that you should start with. But people don't think like that. And they don't realize that. So I try to educate them on that. And we take several pictures. So the pictures are all blown up. And it's not fair to give somebody a mirror and say, look at this and what bothers you. A mirror is this big. That's not fair. You know, you want to see something this big so you can actually look at the whole picture and really look at all angles.
So is there a magnifying process?
Well, I mean, we have huge screen TVs.
Oh, wow.
So we take many pictures. Like, yeah. Pictures aren't glam shots or mug shots, but that's what you want because you want honesty. You know, I mean, if you want honesty, you'll come to me. If you don't, then don't come to me.
Right.
But that's kind of the way I look at it. And I, like I said, the consultations, I kind of go over everything. And if you don't want to hear everything, I don't have to go over that. I go over just what's bothering you. But I try to talk to you about what the process is.
So what are some, I know like for my mom who's watching, hi, those are my family members from San Antonio that are watching. So my cousin Patricia is watching. Hi, Patty Diaz. Listen, I know a lot of you had questions for me today. And I said, this is the perfect person to ask. I am nowhere near familiar with any of these processes. I have used some processes myself, but I don't know really what is now, you know, what is current? What can people do now that maybe they couldn't do 10 years ago? So kind of talk us through that.
So what people, I mean, usually aesthetically, you look at neuromodulators. Neuromodulators are like Botox, Xeomin, Dysport.
Okay.
So there's three on the market now.
Okay.
So they all have the same active ingredients, a little different recipe. Just depends on, I mean, I kind of talk to you about the different ones and which one works best for you. Mm-hmm. So those type of things relax the muscles. Mm-hmm. When they relax the muscles, they lift. And so they help smooth out muscles. They last about 3 to 4 months. Then your muscles wake back up, remember the motion, they start doing it again. So it is maintenance. But I will say the good thing about any neuromodulator, it's temporary. The bad thing is temporary. So you got to maintain.
So you got to find a good, even rhythm,
you do. And if you do it and you stop, it's not everything's not going to fall down. It's not that a misconception.
Your whole face is not going to fall.
Right,
no. Yeah.
But it's something that you can try out,
mm-hmm.
and it goes away. It's
mm-hmm.
not the end of the world. You can try it out, and it's okay. But that's a neuromodulator, which is like Botox, Xeomin, or Dysport. Then you have fillers.
Mm-hmm.
Fillers replace lost volume. So we lose volume as we age. Everybody's different. I will say it's not McDonald's. At least I'm not McDonald's. So when I go in, that's why I take time with people. So that way you're able to say, okay, everybody's different.
Mm-hmm.
So I go over that. And I go over the different fillers that are out on the market.
Mm-hmm.
Fillers are something that, that again, replace lost volume. It's quick and fast. People typically want non-surgical. You know, they want something that they can walk in and get and then maybe have a day or two of downtime, but nothing horrific.
No.
So my goal when people come in is you want someone to look at you and say, wow, you look great. Never, my God, what's happened?
We don't want a negative. Sure.
I will say never drastic plastic or unnatural. You want it, you know, that's what you want.
And you also mentioned that Your face is the best real estate?
No, your face is the most important, your body, everything is the most important real estate you have, so you need to invest in it. No one else is gonna invest in you if you don't invest in yourself. So when you think about, well, oh my God, it costs this, well, how much does your shirt cost? How much do your shoes cost? Think about how many shoes can we have in a closet?
And add all those up.
And you wear yourself every day. So that boosts you every day you're wearing yourself. So when we look good, we feel good.
Mm-hmm. And this is the first thing that people see.
First thing.
Not your hands. No. People spend a fortune on their nails.
Right.
You know, not your, you know, your bottom or whatever.
No, it's not.
It's this.
Right.
This,
it's your face.
Yeah. They're not even interested in anything until they see your face.
Absolutely.
First.
So when that's what they remember. When you walk into even say a car dealership, just using that, you're going to go towards an attractive person. You're not going to go to someone looking crazy or someone looking, right? I mean, we're human nature. That's what we say. We're visual people.
Yes.
So, I mean, not only that, but everybody's on the market these days. It could be either for, you know, for a male or a female or a job. We're all
in the market.
Yeah, we're all in the market.
Yeah, you know,
it's just
market.
Different. It's different these days. So, I mean, we're all trying to market ourselves.
Right.
So how do you do that?
Right.
You invest in yourself.
Perfect.
Mm-hmm. And getting a new pair of shoes is not investing in yourself. They're not looking at your shoes. They're looking at your head.
At your face.
And really your hands as well.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
mm-hmm.
It's really, it's your face, your neck, and your chest all show signs of aging.
Right.
So you want it to balance. You also don't want a floating face. So your face looks great, but your neck doesn't look like your face. So it's all about balance. And it's about being educated on what you need. You might not need that where someone else needs a little more of that.
Right.
So that's where education comes in.
Okay, and I also, wow, it's fascinating. I could sit here and talk with you for hours. One of the things that I was telling you about earlier, too, is that a lot of people out there, I know my viewers don't really like people to know that they have work done, mm-hmm. right, on their face. It was very faux pas 10 years ago. I mean, when I was doing beauty pageants, nobody ever admitted to having a boob job, but everybody in the pageant had a boob job. I mean, come on, peeps. It's 2018. About to be 2019.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
It's about being the new ageless generation. I really believe that. The 40 and up women, now you can't even really tell how old they are. You know they're no spring chicken. You know they're not 20. But now you really don't know because they've done so well with preventative measures and preventative processes. And they look stunning.
Absolutely.
And they're fierce and ferocious. And let me tell you why. Because they have the maturity and the wherewithal that most 20-year-olds don't have.
Very true.
So then they look fantastic and got this great head on their shoulders. I mean, they're powerhouses, right? And so you are a part of an entrepreneurial group. You want to talk a little bit about that, the group that you're a part of?
Well, I was part of eWomen's Network. So now I'm kind of looking at different networks.
Okay.
So that's one of the ones that I was part of, which is a bunch of basically women that own their own businesses, and it's a great network to work with.
Right, and we talk about it a lot with Bubble Talk about female entrepreneurs and how important it is to surround yourself with other like-minded, driven, positive people. If you continually surround yourself with people who are very positive and you interject, I mean, feel free to interject with anything that I'm saying, great things are going to happen. You're really going to prosper. You're going to start thinking in a more business-like manner.
Absolutely.
You're going to start surrounding yourself with people who are a lot like yourself.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I really truly believe that. So if you're not part of a networking group, there are hundreds out there.
Yes,
there are. I want to make sure if you are a serious entrepreneur, that is how your business is going to grow. Mm-hmm. Networking, networking, and networking.
Yes, absolutely.
And do you feel like that is kind of, you know, attributed to your success is the amount of networking that you do, or you think it's just been?
I think it's a combination.
Okay.
The networking, I think I've done more since we've been in the office, but really, I mean, I have a huge following.
Yes, you do.
Because of how I consult people. I mean, I just really, I take that time, and that's a huge part of it. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can always be bigger, obviously.
Right.
Always be bigger. And again, the networking is definitely making a huge difference with the office now.
And I think knowing her for a very short amount of time, this is the first time I've ever truly met her. I met her at an event here that you hosted, a wonderful, the Red Project fashion show for Houston
Red
AIDS
Production.
Foundation. Red Production, sorry. Okay. I know Boy and Bobby are like, what is she talking about?
We're not perfect.
Yeah. This is live. And So one of the things I think that, and I'm just speaking maybe out of context here for a second, I think that you're very, like, again, nurturing. I can feel that energy, but also very relatable.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that people see a lot of the social media and put people on a different level and think they're unapproachable and not able to relate. And
exactly.
She's very relatable. I mean, I can feel that you're very open to having conversations with people, and people remember that. When you truly connect with people, people want to come back to you. And that's what you said. Not every person's going to come back after every consultation, but they eventually will.
Yeah, they will.
They, because they go to other places, maybe don't get the same warm, fuzzy feeling, don't maybe don't get the same education, because you said education
is key. Huge. Mm-hmm.
And I have personally had those experiences where I've walked into many spas, actually, either looking for sponsorship for Bubble Talk or just looking for processes for myself, and walked out feeling like,
because you want someone that knows what they're talking about. You don't want someone to do anything on you that they don't know what they're doing.
Right. And
it's not just textbook.
Well, and that and the parties and things like that, where I really don't know the doctor. They don't know me. And I feel like it's more like a cattle call kind of feeling. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I'll pass. I'll have some champagne and then I'll go home. And I like what you said, I probably never had that experience where someone actually sits down with me and talks to me about me that has an investment in how I look. And that's what you do here. And then that's what makes you different.
Well, and everybody's an investment. I will say everybody's a piece of art. So you want to see what it takes to make you complete with what you want. I mean, so I will say that you might need a little pink, a little purple, a little green to create that masterpiece. And everybody's a masterpiece. So that's why I look at it. And my name's on your face. So I always want to make sure that I'm doing the best.
You're wearing her name.
Yes.
You're wearing her name. So you've had, I'm going to show, several articles written about you. How does that feel? How does that make you feel every time someone wants to come in and interview you and write an article about you? Or like today, I was chomping at the bit. I know you're busy to interview. How does that make, is that important to you?
It's important to me. It makes me feel good. It makes me a little nervous because I mean, I'm great when I'm talking to patients because I do it all day long every day, but I'm not so good sometimes when I'm talking about myself.
And where do you aspire? I mean, where do you see yourself in the future? Do you want to be more philanthropic? I know you already do a lot of fundraising type activity, but I mean, do you want to continue to build this practice and other practices? I mean, where do you see yourself? What are your goals?
Making a difference in people's lives, I think that's the biggest thing for me, making a difference.
Okay.
And that's what I want to do. I want to make a difference in people's life. I love what I do, and I think how fortunate and I am to be able to do what I love. A lot of people don't do what they love.
Absolutely.
And they're stuck in the rat race.
Yes.
I don't want to be stuck in the rat race.
Like a hamster on a wheel.
Exactly. And you're just, you're trying to catch your tail. I don't want to be that person.
Right.
And if you can do what you love, just how fortunate you are.
Yeah. I think that you guys, this is episode 30, so every opportunity I get to interview someone, I always come away with something about their story. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the things that I have found, the common denominator between every successful entrepreneur, female or male, has been that they wanted to make a difference and that they want to continue to help people. And people, when you sincerely want to help people, they remember you. Mm-hmm. When you're a taker and you're constantly taking from people, nobody remembers a taker.
No, they don't.
People only remember givers.
That's very true.
You know, when you're in your darkest moment, when you're at your most lowest moment, when someone gives you that piece of bread and you're hungry or gives you the extra $100 to pay your light bill or whatever it is that your strife and struggles.
That's very true.
And for me, even though this, these articles, I'm sure, speak volumes about you. I know who did this one, Bobby and Boy, right? This is Luxor Magazine, where beauty and art come together, aesthetically speaking. An article written about Kay. So Kay, tell me a little bit more about your family and your background and now where do you live? Do you still live in the Sharpstown area?
No, I live in Sugarland.
Okay.
I live in Sugarland. I have a sister. She's 10 years older than me. My mother's passed away 7 years ago. My father's still alive. Have a wonderful stepmother. I don't call her stepmother. It just sounds so ugly. Yeah. Stepmother. I say my dad's wife.
Yeah.
I mean, she's wonderful. Yeah. And I have two children.
Thank you.
I have a 24-year-old son, and I have a 23-year-old daughter, and I have a beautiful granddaughter, a 10-month-old granddaughter.
Oh, yeah.
So family's very important.
Yes, yes, yes. I have a 25-year-old and a 3-year-old grandson. And my 17-year-old at home, Thomas, who, by the way, called me literally during this broadcast. So I just want to say, seriously, Thomas?
what do they call you? What's your name?
Well, I'm Mom to everybody. And then my grandbaby calls me Mom. He's half Vietnamese, mm-hmm. half Mexican. Mm-hmm. So I'm really a Benoit, but he calls me mom because his mom's the first mom and then I'm the second mom. So he calls me two moms in a row.
I'm KK.
KK. I'm KK. And they're amazing. Green kids are amazing. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Well, I just want to say thank you so, so much. What, where can they find you, Kay? If someone wants to reach you, give us your social media platforms.
Phone number is 713-LIP-5656. That's the number to reach us. Address is 8200 West Glen Drive. We're off of West Park Tollway in between Hillcroft and Fondren.
Okay.
Other than that, it would be beautiful, B-E-Y-O-U.
Okay.
Beautiful anti-aging studio.
Okay. On West Glen.
On West Glen.
On West Glen. Mm-hmm. I want to say hi to, hey, Sabi, how are you? Sylvia Navarro, how are you? So we have a couple of viewers over here. Randall says, hello. Great backdrop. Hi, Randall. How are you? So it's not letting us show. Hmm. Oh, there we go. Brandon Allen. Randall Chestnut. Oh, my mom. Hi, mom. Mary Helen. She's saying very good information. Brandon Allen. Kyle Green. Hey, Kyle from South Carolina. How are you, Kyle? My child. Hi, Kyle. How are you? He keeps on me because he wants me to write a book. Because he inspires people. And he's called 400 times. Angelina Sandoval Martinez, how are you guys? So I have two cameras going, so we're having to look back and forth here. You guys, listen, if you have any doubt, if you have any question, Kay is here to educate you, to educate you about the different processes that are available to you. And you don't do anything that you don't want to do.
Absolutely not.
You know, you want to feel extremely comfortable with anything that you're ever going to do to your body or to your face. And having a good fit with someone, you guys need to come check out Kay here at McCunis. Amazing. And the art. In a minute, I'm going to do a live and show you some of her pieces. So stay tuned on my page. I'll try to do it from the Bubble Talk page as well, but we'll see how that works out.
I will say when you do something, you should do it for yourself, not for anybody else.
Correct.
Absolutely. It should just be something that bothers you, not that bothers.
That's a great piece
of
advice.
Your husband, your brother,
boyfriend,
your mother,
yeah.
Anybody. It should be
for you.
It bothers you. Yeah.
Yeah, for you. For you.
Absolutely.
You guys, I want to thank my sponsors, Bella Soleil. She's the luxury mobile tanning, Tiffany Banks. You can go to her page. I'll put it in the description on Facebook. I want to thank Northside Imports and Northside Maserati for the beautiful 2019 Levante and 2019 Jubilee that's outside. You guys, I want to say thank you for always being so patient today with us, but always watching Bubble Talk. We're here to inspire you to live your life outside its present boundaries. Be open to people. Be open to new concepts. Mm-hmm. And I want to say thank you so much. I know you guys are so busy mm-hmm. and you
Thanks
took the time to come. And we want to say thank you for following Bubble Talk. Until next week, episode 31, we'll see you. Good night.
Night.